very important chain of tables to do with the days of the Omer, of the important mitzvah of the Omer. Now this is in Hebrew really, Sikta Rav Kana, which says, Rav Kana Amar Le'ula, Lo Tehe Mitzvat HaOmer Kala Be'inecha, She'adim Mitzvat HaOmer Zachah Avinu Avrinu L'Reshet Eretz Kna'an, Ad Avdechti V'Natati L'cha Zaracha Et Eretz Megurecha. Now this is in English, what you are going to see now, is a translation of it, and this is what he's saying. Rav Yochanan said to Ulam, the commandments of the Omer, you know the commandments of the Omer is to bring the offering of the Omer, which we mentioned, and these commandments of the Omer will not be easy in your eyes, because by the commandments of the Omer, our fathers Abraham inherited the land of Canaan, as it is written, and I gave you and your descendants after you the land of your dwelling place. My covenant shall be preserved. This is a condition. Sometimes they forget it. Yeah, it was a nice lecture in the United Nations, which the ambassador of Israel said, Danone, and really, he mentioned this verse, the Torah, God, say that he gave us the land, but he forgot to mention, maybe he forgot or not, but that it's a condition that he should keep the covenant. He said, so what, it's about, it's today a little bit, don't keep it so properly. So this is really very interesting Midrash homiletic, which tells us about the importance of this mitzvah of the Omer. Now basically the mitzvah of the Omer, as you know, is to bring from the barley, offering to God, you know, this is the Melech after Pesach. Now, Brit Milah, the covenant is a circumcision, Brit Milah. Now, there is connection between them, very likely, this is what it looks like from the commentators, because both represent the faith in God, and both represent the idea that materialism should be refined and kept in the light of the Torah, with the commandments. And this is exactly what the circumcision does, cutting away the very, very, how you call it, you know, very, very thick materialism, yeah? And makes, it's fine, refined. And this is exactly the Omer, bringing this barley, lifting it up, and really declaring and saying that the God is, God is the owner of the world. The world belongs to him. So faith in the Torah, in God, is the most important and the basis of these commandments of the Omer, and in this merit, faith in God, keeping the Torah and mitzvot, refining the physical, this is the merit for Israel to get the land. This is what is written here. Amazingly, what you are going to see now is a chain of tables in the Torah, Torah codes, Bible codes, clearly shows it. Now what you have here, the first thing, this is really the place of this Midrash homiletic, which says, Natati lecha lezaracha acharecha teretz megurecha et kol eretz Kna'an. God says to Abraham, I will give to you and your descendants after you the land you are dwelling, the old land of Kna'an. Yeah, even the land of Kna'an is for Israel, not like Abu Mazen said he's a Canaanite, so the land should belong to him, but he forgets that God says that he will give the land of Canaan l'achuzat olam for eternal inheritance to Israel. But the condition, you want the land, the full Israel, complete one. At Brit Yishmo, you have to give my covenant, circumcision. Brit is a Torah. The service is called Brit, Brit Olam. Now you want the full land of Israel, you want peace and quiet, yeah. This is the condition. This is what somehow the ambassador of Israel, Danny Denon, forgot. Did not say in the nice speech that he did. So this comes, by the way, all these verses with the quarrel over Jerusalem with the Arabs, Ishmael, because they claim, the Arabs say, we also circumcised, but as Kabbalah says, as Zohar says, that they don't fulfill it properly. They don't do it exactly as Jews did, not for mitzvah. So therefore they will not get the land, this was the Zohar says, only when the land will be empty, but when Israel, Jews will come out, then they will not. But it is interesting that it's written here at Brit, the Brit, the covenant, Akimet Yitzchak, we say with Isaac, and when, amazingly, my small skip of the year, Tavshin Kaf Vav, 5726. What happened there? This was the eve of the 6 day war. By the way, this is the date which is written in the Kabbalah about getting back Jerusalem. So, interesting is this verse exactly fits with what the Midrash says. You want the full Israel, you want peace and quiet in Israel? Yeah. Keep the Torah, keep the Sabbath, the Brit, keep the Inquisition, keep the Torah, all is called Brit. Now let us see other verses which clearly they say the same thing. And here is another one. We have in the Torah a Brit Milah, it means the circumcision. Interesting. A Brit Milah. It comes in the book of Numbers, and in this place we have the verses when God says to Jews, Natati et ha'aretz lerishta, I give you the land to inherit it. And you will inherit it in the... All the borders comes here. We're not going to all the borders, but the border for Maale Akrabim, the Negev, and all over, which is a very, very wide area. And it, God said, I will give it to you, but condition, Milah, circumcision, and Brit Milah. By the way, one of the signs for a good table, Torah table, Professor Ripstein always to show is, we have a parallel with the same verse, like you have your, the Milah, you have the covenant here, the covenant again. It shows, it gives a lot of strength to the code. Now, what you have here also very interesting, you have is to get the land, we have to keep the mitzvot, the Brit, the Torah, the Shabbat, and so on. So, unfortunately, it looks like it will be when the son of Jesse will come. Yeah, many shy definitely go together. When you keep the Torah, the Shabbat, you have the son of Jesse, Mashiach. And the first Mashiach, who is really paving the way for son of David, is son of Yosef, Ben Yosef, the children of Yosef. They were going to carry on the wars and whatever they needed to Israel will get their land. Then son of David will come. And again, a promise God said, this is the land which you will inherit, and with all these very wide borders. And again, Britain, again, Tova Haaretz, this land which God gives us is very good. But Milah, Milah, you need the circumcision, you need the purity. Amazing. Then another table, another place, also in Genesis, by the way, you can say, Aleph, Genesis, really. It is a few verses, in chapters, really, in Genesis, in which we find amazingly, this is, by the way, Doron Wissum found it, and he found the Kiyum Mitzvot, with the establishment, fulfilling commandments, then what will be? So God said to Abraham, Bayar Hashem al Avraham, Bayom Elo, Lezaracha eten et ha'aretz hazot, I will give this land Israel to your descendants. But this is what Abraham did, by Shmor Mishmarti, he kept my guardians, Mitzvotai, he kept my commandments, Machukotai, my laws, my Torah. This is, by this, if you keep the Torah fully, yeah, then you will get the full land. If not, today, not yet really. Proper Jerusalem, not yet, yes, proper land. And still we need to do this mitzvot, Shabbos and so on, which we have, unfortunately, people like Lapid and Lieberman who don't allow it. Let us see more. This is, as we said before, but really fully. You have clearly all the details of the Brit Milah, lo tetamei et ha'aretz, don't defile the land, you know. And defiling the land, you know, homosexualism, all these things, and this which, unfortunately, as the Torah said afterwards, vomits Israel out of the land. That is the expression. So here also, it's inquisition parallel, this one. And again, Brit and sons of Yosef, what we saw before in a full picture. Then, again, you have something very interesting, appearance of Eretz Israel, the land of Israel, and also, depend on the Torah, also the promise you will come to the land, promise to Israel, to get the land Hashlema, but, as we said, keeping the Torah. Without the Torah, will not help you anything. So altogether, as we said, important tables. And all are going together, what Rabbi Yochanan said to Ula, he said more than 2,000 years ago. Yeah. And he said, the commander of the owner, don't be light in your eyes, yeah. Because yeah, it easily really mean light, is a proper translation, will not be light in your eyes, because it is very severe, because the commandments of the Omer, our father, and the merit of it, Abraham, our father, inherited the land of Canaan. As it is written, and I gave you and your descendants after you the land of your dwelling place, Genesis 17:8. My covenant shall be preserved. All in Bereshit. So very important chain of tables clearly shows that in the merit of covenant, Sabbath, Bet Milah, and all these things, we'll get the full land of Israel, and only then we'll have peace, quiet, and tranquility, and we'll have the son of Jesse, as you see, a Messiah coming, and peace, tranquility will prevail in Israel, in the whole world.